So here we are, deep in a ravine. In the Dolomite Mountains, we find the Italian resort of Madonna di Campiglio, famous for the Hapsburgs, who have been coming here for centuries. But now, it's a different type of glitterati. The wealthy residents in their fur coats just perambulate around for hours and hours on end. They're not the ones that go up for the skiing. The skiing is more for the wealthy Brits, the wealthy Germans, and the Italians. But we also find the young of all nations coming here to enjoy what is a really special location. This week we've chosen to follow a group of posing British skiers who are here to enjoy the ambience and the nightlife, and indeed the skiing, of which there is much to be seen in and throughout the resort. But what sort of issues do we expect to cover during this week? Will the snow be deep enough? Will Mike and Tessa ever finish arguing? Will Kevin get rid of his rubbishy red coat and trade it in for something more sophisticated, like a rather nice fur coat? But most of all, how many people will we see falling down this run? And more importantly, will they ever stop talking about golf? But now let's go and meet some of those glitterati. And here they are, the glitterati themselves, fresh from being on the slopes.
Piss off, paparazzi.
Don't they look a picture of health and wealth? And surely these people have come a long way to ski today. Oh, here we are, deep in the Dolomites, and it's a bright sunny morning. We had about an inch of snow last night, or 25 millimetres if you like to be Italian. And we're in a hotel which is almost exclusively Italian, which is great because nobody understands a word we're saying, and the menu has to be seen to be believed. Terrific stuff. I mean, last night we had angry pasta, and tonight we have soup of the beautiful English woman. God only knows what it's going to be like, but the sun's out, so we're going out.
There's some assistance from the old cameraman.
Thank you, Sue.
So Mike's left his gloves where, Tess?
Upstairs, five floors upstairs.
And who's going to get them?
Six floors upstairs, actually, isn't it, from here down there?
From here, yes. And who's offered to get them?
Well, I haven't offered.
Nobody's offered to get them.
But?
Who's been tortured and told they've got to get them?
So I'll leave it offered. I'll leave these keys at the reception, shall I?
It's Fantastic Housewives, Dick Chocolate.
Yeah, Housewife's Gardening.
Housewife's Gardening Chocolate, that's what it's doing.
The lift I was looking at Prada Lager, you actually gave me. And I was like, oh, yeah.
Can you see
that
they're
going down. Can you say that again?
Just come up.
No,
just
to that house.
And pass that right hand.
I think you go under the chair and the
state
you look
really.
This is the guy that got lost this morning, so I wouldn't take much note of that. It's the Peace Police.
They've
seen got a blue light police. Flashing on it.
No, they've seen your skiing.
Well,
it's completely flat now, isn't it? Look.
You don't know we can get across. Possibly down
wait,
here.
Oh, now
that's okay. Okay.
I don't think that worked.
15 giorni c'era la neve.
Well, I used to take one there, definitely.
This is all growing as a big meal. Yeah. Yeah.
How much further can you slump down in this chair?
Enough that I'm out of the picture.
What?
Right, you point out the better ones.
Well, they've gone.
Oh, no, this one there.
Yeah, well, this one, no, that's a cheapie.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, that'll be a cheapie.
Excuse me, madam, you've got a cheap fur coat.
Bloody pain.
BBC. We're waiting now. We've been waiting 20 minutes, so I thought instead of actually waiting for the fireworks, we'd have a look at some of the enthralled spectators now who are waiting for this magnificent event. Kevin, stand still on your feet, will you please? Okay, we'll ask the crowd for the candid opinions on this then, shall we?
Well, I think if this was in the United Kingdom, it would be far better than this.
Well, I have to concur with Kevin. I think absolutely. I mean, it's just not on, is it?
No. Oh,
it's nice.
Watching the same thing go back
up now.
Oh, we're all lining up now.
Tessa's asked me to film this one. She says this is somebody in a proper fur coat. And I bet something might just possibly be happening up here. Look, there's a post.
Oh,
That's why they wanted the water.
What?
Oh, he's lost stuff.
He's split up there.
He's split up. He's had enough of that.
They hit a bit of ice there, aren't
they?
With the votes of the British jury now, please.
Yes, very good, very good.
I think we could give them
9 out of 10.
Oh, it's another one.
Oh, look,
that's the official one. This is going
to be the team. E per concludere questa regale serata, Sissi, accompagnata da un figlio...
Keep your wig on, Cathy.
And did the father gave move? No, not an inch.
No. It was French, actually.
What?
John Simpson's book says you can turn those little red lights off.
Well, you splat them, can you?
No, they used to say Kiddie the Taliban. They weren't filming because they let only film when the red light was on. Well, they didn't tweet that they could turn the light off.
Let's go up there at the back. Look at where James is. Oh, James just came down. What's that name? What?
What are we going to do next then? Well, I've answered
the disappears.
Okay, Mike, are you ready?
We're going down to where you'd be, mate.
very rude phrase that you got from someone.
You should have had the red light flashing.
I just dropped the hose on it.
Is the red light on?
No.
I didn't
hear it. I know it's running.
No, it isn't really. Just tell us what it is. Tell us what this phrase that tells Italians to F off is, please. I'll play this bit of you. So there you have it. There you have it. It's the end, and now they're just waiting to go back home. Will the coach come down here? Probably not. Will it come up here? Also probably not.
Will we still be here an hour's time?
Probably.
And will the glitterati, in all their finery, actually have to lug their suitcases across the bloody market square just one more time?